So we are going to find equation of the surface that's obtained by revolving the graph of z equals natural log of y about the z-axis. That is, first let's look at it in a basic manner. That is, we are revolving it around the z-axis, and here I'm trying to make the x-axis here. So it is going to be a surface traced by the revolution of this curve. So in that surface, let me just give you a computer generated image. That's going to look like this. Now what we will do is, let's go ahead and take a section of this surface by a plane that's parallel to the xy plane, or in other words, by a plane, say z equals z sub p, where zp is a particular value of z. So see, this will be a circle, okay, because the radius of the revolution will be the same. So this is going to be a circle, and the circle is in the plane z equals zp. So then I just did this, that I intersected it with the plane x equals 0, which is the yz plane, just to show you this, that see, this is our curve that's like generating this whole thing, and zp was our particular value of z, and y sub p, let's let that be the particular value of y that corresponds to this point. And of course, in here the x coordinate will be 0, and the form of the equation for this point, the equation would be satisfied, our original equation, that is z equals natural log of y. So if we go further, I took the plane away just to avoid confusion. So here we have our point 0, yp, zp, and we are going to concentrate on this circle, which is in the plane z equals zp, to get the surface. Okay, so let's see this here. This is the circle, okay, that we have there, and this is the radius of this. This is a radius of the circle. Graphically, I meant. Okay, so if we go further, this is also a radius, and of course, in this three-dimensional picture, they don't look equal, but you know, they will have to be equal. And what I've just done is this. Let's see this logarithmic equation, zp equals natural log of y sub p. I changed it to exponential equation, y sub p equals e to the power z sub p. Okay, so now this value here is the particular value of y, which equals e to the power zp, and of course this r will have to be the same. So let's look at that in our other sketches. So r has to be e to the zp for this entire circle. R means the radius of the circle that we got in that section. So if we continue to look at that, let's take a typical point. Okay, and one more thing, that the equation of this circle will be what? R equals e to the z, because e to the z is the radius. And then if we go further, then what happened is, yes, I'm taking this here. Now a point here, what I did was, you know, this was the point corresponding to the yz plane, and this is a typical point here in the plane z equals zp, and there we will have x, y, and this particular value of z, because we are still staying in the z equals zp plane. Okay, now I'm taking that circle in the z equals zp plane, and you can see throughout on the circumference of this circle, z is staying as zp, a z sub p. Radius is e to the power zp, okay? And if we look at this, then what has to happen is that, notice, x square plus y square will have to be the radius square. And who is the radius? E to the power zp, okay? And square of that is what? E to the power 2zp. Now, going back, we can now let zp be any value. So what that surface is, that surface is the accumulation of circles, okay, with radius varying according to this rule with the changing values of z. So all that will happen is x square plus y square, well, that will be for any point on the surface, and that will equal to e to the power 2. Here I have it for zp, but when I let it go through all such circles, the equation will be x square plus y square equals e to the 2z. Okay, so just combine that with the notes and let me know if you still have any questions. All right.